I got these Ohuhu gel pens a little while back, so I'm going to give you guys my review on them today. I got this pack of 20 for $10. For such a low-cost pen, they're really great quality. The pack came with a variety of colors and multiple silver, golds, and white pens, which is really great because those are the ones I use the most. They write really smooth, and the color shows really vibrant on black and white paper. Overall, I'd give these pens an A. I'm going to give you guys my review on these Zebra Midliner brush pen markers. These markers are double-ended with one brush tip and one super fine tip. I got the fluorescent pack, which includes blue, blue-green, yellow, orange, and pink. The brush tips draw smooth. The colors blend well into each other, but they are just a tad bit streaky. I really like the blue-green color in this pack. I think it's one I'm going to get a lot of use out of. Overall, I'd give these markers a B minus. I'm going to give my review on these handmade modern paint markers from Target. This pack was $10 for a set of 8. The paint applies smooth and evenly, and the pigment is nice and vibrant. I decided to try them out on this small flower pot. I have a lot of control over where the paint goes. I was happy with how easily it was to make small details. The paint dries with a glossy finish. They're super fun and not too messy. I would give these markers a B plus. Here's my follow-up review for the Sakura Jelly Roll pens. In my first review, the pack that I got really just didn't work, so I give it a low grade. I went back to the store and I found ones that I could individually test out before buying. I'm trying out the Moonlight and the Stardust pens. The Moonlight pens are supposed to be bright and vibrant on light or dark paper, and the Stardust ones have a glittery sparkle effect that shows best on lighter paper. I like the pens that I chose. The effects work well and they draw smooth. These are better than the ones from before, but after seeing that you guys had similar issues, my rating is going to stay the same. I would not buy these pens again unless I was going to test them out beforehand. Overall, I give these a 4 out of 10. I just got these Ohuhu brush markers this week, so here's my review on them. I got the 48 pack for $28, making each marker about 53 cents a piece. It came with a canvas case and color swatch papers that I think are super handy. It comes with a wide variety of different colors and shades. These draw pretty smooth, like with no streaks, and they blend really well into one another. These are easily comparable to Copic markers. They are almost identical in quality. The biggest difference is the price. For the price that I got the 48 of these, I could have only gotten 3 or 4 Copic markers. And they come with reversible tips that you can just flip over if you ever need to replace one. I think that these are amazing for the price, quality, and variety of colors. Overall, I give these markers a 10 out of 10.